Dear friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Suman and I make videos on working in UK as a doctor. Thank you for watching, appreciating and engaging with my last video on why I moved to UK from India. Some of you have asked to share the ways by which you can enhance your income while working as a junior doctor in the UK. In this video, I am going to discuss the methods which I personally use to supplement my income. For ease of understanding, I am going to broadly divide the income streams into two categories, active income and passive income. But before I go into the details, let me make it clear that I am not going to disclose the exact income that I get through these streams. Rather, I will give you a tentative range or a tentative amount for your understanding. This is different from my previous video where I disclosed the exact income that I get from NHS salary, because the salary of an NHS junior doctor, or in my case a registrar, is publicly available information on the internet and anyone can access them. Everything I am sharing today is for information purposes only, and this should not be considered as a financial advice. If you don't know the difference between an active and passive income, then let me make it very clear at the beginning. Active income means any income for which I have to trade my time. For example, working as a doctor in a hospital or even making these YouTube videos. So for this, I have to actively trade my time to make some money. A passive income is something that doesn't need my time. For example, I invest in an equity market and I'm making profit from that. That does not need my time. So this is a passive investment. The most important way to earn extra money while working as a doctor in NHS is to work as a locum doctor. Most hospitals will have unfilled positions on their on-call rota or their usual day-to-day jobs, and they will need doctors to fulfill those gaps. This is where the locum doctor comes in. Sometimes there could be last minute gaps because of staff shortage or staff sickness. The locum doctor is not always an employee of the hospital. Rather, they are employed by a medical bank or locum agency. Some specialties, for example, acute medicine, might have more options of locum slots than some other specialties, like for example psychiatry. I tend to work locum shifts in my own hospital because I don't feel comfortable going to an unknown hospital to work as a doctor. But if you're comfortable, you can register with a locum agency. You can go to work in any hospital. In the region of UK where I work, the locum shifts for a medical registrar are paid approximately £60 to £80 an hour, depending on social hours or unsocial hours. Of course, you have to pay tax on the total income that you earn from locum shifts. This is by far the most lucrative way of earning money as a doctor in the NHS. You can also work as a full-time locum doctor and get paid on an hourly basis, provided your visa status allows you, which is a problem for an international medical graduate. But for working as a locum, you will never progress in your career. That is why I am working in a training post and not in a locum post, accepting a lower pay than a locum. The way I plan my locum shifts is to use this money for some form of a non-essential purchase or buying a luxury item. For example, when I wanted to buy a new phone, I didn't want to spend my salary to buy that phone. Rather, I did a locum shift, a 12-hour locum shift as a medical registrar in my hospital, and from that money, I could afford to buy a Pixel 5 phone. In general, to give you a rough estimate, I make approximately 6,000 to 8,000 pounds by working as a locum in my own hospital. Another source of income as a doctor is to participate in paid market surveys. There are many market research companies which will pay doctors to complete research surveys. You should be careful not to disclose any patient information in these surveys. Personally, I always avoid surveys which deals with any form of a patient related information. I can earn anything between 150 to 200 pounds per year from these surveys. Research is another way by which you can earn some extra money. I often participate in research projects as a medical expert and offer consultancy to pharma companies. Most of these projects will end up in a research publication in a renowned medical journal. Pharma companies will often pay me an honorarium to offer medical expert advice. But for this kind of invitation, you will need to have some publication and establish yourself as a key opinion leader in your field. I make approximately 1,000 to 1,500 pounds from this kind of research projects. Another common form of earning some money available to most junior doctors in the hospital is by completing legal certificates. The commonest of them is a cremation form, which the ward doctors have to complete. This fee for completing the cremation form is paid for by the funeral directors. Sometimes there are other legal forms that a doctor will have to complete. In my specialty as a respiratory doctor, the consultants will often be asked to provide opinion about fitness to drive for patients with sleep apnea, and they will get a professional fee for this kind of legal certificate. Another source of income for me in 2021 is this YouTube channel. I started this YouTube channel in the end of January 2021, and I know as a YouTube channel, I'm in a very early stages, and I am not expecting that I'll be making any money from this channel in next 12 months. However, I was lucky to get a sponsorship deal with one of the companies, and I got paid a very small fee to do a video for them. For monetizing your YouTube channel, the criteria is you have to attain 1,000 subscribers, which I have done thanks to you all. But the other criteria is to attend 4,000 watch hours, which I'm not even halfway through. Thank you everyone for supporting my channel, and I never thought that I will gain 1,000 subscribers, which is now possible thanks to your well wishes. Till now, I have received 25 pounds from my YouTube channel, but most importantly, I have received many well wishers which money can't buy. If you are one of them, please click the like button to let me know. If you are a new viewer to my channel today, then please press the subscribe button if you want to get more of similar contents. Till now, I have discussed about the active income streams, and now I will be moving on to the passive income streams. Now, the most important passive stream of income for me is investments. To be specific, equity investments. If you have watched my previous videos on how to grow your wealth as an IMG doctor in UK, I have discussed about how to invest in the equity markets. I have my investment both in UK market as well as Indian markets. First, let me discuss about the UK investments. I started investing in the UK markets last year in May 2020. As you might know that the equity markets all over the world, they slumped in March 2020 due to the coronavirus pandemic. This was one of the reasons when I became very aggressive with my investment portfolio and I entered the UK markets. Following the slump in March 2020, the markets have now recovered and there had been a rally in most of the equity markets all over the world. Because of this rally, it made me a significant return of my investment in last 12 months. From my UK investment, I made a profit of approximately 2,400 pounds in last 12 months. Most importantly, this is a tax-free profit because in UK, we have the option of investing in something called ISA account or individual savings account, where all the profit from your investments becomes tax-free. Now, coming to my Indian investments, as you might know from my previous videos, I tend to keep all my savings in the Indian markets for the simple reason that I believe that the Indian markets will grow significantly faster than what the UK markets will do. I have been investing in the Indian markets for more than last 5 years, and predominantly I invest in equity markets through mutual funds. After the Sensex went down in March 2020, over the next few months, I increased my investment in the Indian markets through mutual fund, and over the last 12 months, as you know, the markets have recovered dramatically, which made me a significant profit in my Indian portfolio. In last 12 months, I made a profit of approximately £9,000 from my Indian portfolio alone. But please bear in mind, this kind of profit was possible only because of the coronavirus pandemic. Otherwise, it's not usual to get this kind of a mind-blowing profit every year. If you have also been investing in Indian markets, then I'm sure you are very happy about the performance of the Sensex in last 1 year. Please hit the like button to show your love for the Sensex. Referral bonus from various utility providers is another form of passive income which I have managed to generate over the last 12 months. In UK, this is a common business practice that if you can refer a customer to a energy company, telephone or broadband provider, or even a house builder, then you can earn a commission because you are referring a new customer. I've referred some of my friends and colleagues to this kind of utility providers, and we both have earned some money in return. In last 1 year, I made approximately £750 from all this referral bonus. So friends, this was a quant heavy video with lots of number crunching. If you're still with me, then by now you should have an idea about what are the possible sources of supplementing your income while working as a doctor in the UK. To summarize, I made approximately £19,000 from non-salary related income in last 1 year. Out of this, the most lucrative and the easily available source of extra income is locum income, and that forms the bulk of your total income. Please let me know whether you have any further questions on these topics, and don't forget to like this video if you like more similar contents. See you next time.